Philippine shares fall for a fourth straight day. The main index now back at the 6,100 level after shedding 0.8%. For the week, the PSEI is also down by 2.6%. Value turnover continued to be below average daily transactions. The decline comes after Philippine Central Bank Governor Felipe Medalla signaled more rate hikes a day after delivering a surprise 75 basis point increase. But Adrian Yu of COL Financial says the rate hike should be viewed as a positive development.
I think it was much needed, and definitely it should help combat inflation, considering it should give some support to the weakening peso. So I think that should be a positive in general, considering how behind the curve we are.
He expects the main index to end the year at the 7,700 level.
With regards to the current sell-off, I think this has much to do with the global foreign sell-off and weakness in the market rather than the off-cycle rate hike.
Rob Ramos of RCBC sees the Philippine Central Bank hiking interest rates further to 4.75% to 5% until the end of the year.
Borrowing costs may increase. Firms looking to borrow and expand may be more wary of doing so at this time. The same can be said of individual borrowers, and that can be a great concern. That being said, I personally believe that the country still has a capability to pay its debt quite comfortably. I personally believe that the Philippine economic team would be quite on top of managing our debt burden. I also believe that the credit rating is something that the economic team would like to maintain, so that this would be monitored accordingly. Case in point, you know, we're at the 60 debt to GDP level, quite at par with other countries within our region, are actually a little better. I think the concern usually stems from the fact that compared to the pre-pandemic years, we were at 40.
Rain Musngi, ABS-CBN News.